On the 13th of February 2023, Eric Mwesigwa appeared at the NUP party offices with fresh burns, claiming he had been abducted by security agencies and tortured. However, yesterday Mwesigwa retracted his story and accused NUP of luring him into a dirty deal with an aim of tarnishing the government's name. Mwesigwa, who was flanked by the army spokesperson, Brigadier Felix Kulaije, claimed that the National Unity Platform planned and conducted his kidnap and subsequent torture after promising him 50 million shillings and a trip abroad.
Twapanga ekintu kino eyantukira bamuyita King Zari. King Zari abera ku guard ya kibanda akolanga bodyguard wa Bobby Wine. Nandukira mu kintu chonna ngawe kintu sikanduka akola nego tofa yotogenda togenda uri ya pain yona. So baja ne bakukwata nga obakukwata baine biso bakukuba no banga tosa uri ya pain yona yona yona. Ne bakola ibakukoze ne bakutochali ngana ne bakuswaji bakusude. Bamalo kusula ne bakujani be flat ba government ya kusude ne bakutwala mu dwali yona ne bakukwa treatment.
The National Unity Platform nope have over time made it a norm to parade people with bodily defects occasioned by normal accidents to masquerade as victims of torture inflicted on them by security personnel. Recently, on the 13th of February 2023, one Mwesigwa Eric was paraded before the media by new President Robert Kyagulanyi at new offices in Kamwocha, Kampala, claiming that he was tortured and burnt on his chest using a flat iron by security operatives.
Addressing the media this afternoon, the National Unity Platform Party President Robert Kyagulanyi described these claims as shameless, scandalous, and amateurish attempt by the UPDF to cover up for its wrongdoings.
Changing the narrative and turning around to say, instead, we are the ones that tortured him. I want to state as follows, that the regime, the shameless and criminal regime of General Museveni, is at it again. You must all have heard the audios that were recorded prior to that press conference when the deals were being discussed between the regime and Eric Mwesigwa in order to compromise him and make him change his words. This is happening because the regime is frightened, first of all, ashamed internationally because of the unacceptable behavior and treatment of citizens.
In the same meeting yesterday was a one Joseph Kadu, who claimed he had also been approached and promised money by the NUP if he accepted to be tortured like Mwesigwa. Kyagulanyi further rubbishes Kadu's claims, saying this is one of the moves for Kadu to gain economic gains and favors from the government.
What the drone is wambachi? Abantu government wambachi? Abantu. Nekati katubabuli la mazima. Nti NUP ena drone yayo bwemenya ati Kadu omanyikiddwa oliwe NUP bagamba Kadu millions zino tano soko ziteke waka etu kina kwa miuni emira amaika atano twa tukuje ku stage wokolera tukutwale tuna mindenje tugundo kola tule government tujirabise.
Today I saw a one Joseph Kadu claiming to be a brother to Eric Mwesigwa. Interestingly, the same Joseph Kadu was used years ago in the case against General Kaihura to also lie in the same way. So I wonder when the military, especially the spokesperson of the military, Felix Kulaije, wants to project a Polish Ugandan to present himself to be the example of the same, because we expected him or them to be smarter than that. We are informed that then in the Kaihura case, they were each given 25 million. They came out to confess.
Kyagulanyi further appealed to the Ugandans to stay alert and desist such lies that are meant to hoodwink them.
Addressing this matter to show you how shameless the Museveni regime is. But again, I encourage you, ladies and gentlemen, don't stop. Those on the internet, on social media, and every Ugandan who can raise a voice, don't stop raising your voice. This regime continues to embarrass itself, to expose itself because of your pressure. Please do not stop.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.